Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. In this video, we define even functions, and we provide two examples of even functions, and then we determine whether each of the four functions here is even or not. All right, we're going to be discussing even functions. A function f is called an even function if whenever the ordered pair xy is on the graph of f, so is negative xy. So if you have some x coordinate with some y value, there's also the opposite of that x coordinate. So if you have 2, 3, you'll also have negative 2, 3, for instance. So this is how we define an even function right here. In the box, that's the definition. A function f is even if for every x in the domain, negative x is also in the domain, and f of negative x equals f of x. That means when you plug in negative x for x, you get exactly the same function. The graph of an even function is symmetric with the y-axis. So here are some examples of even functions. F of x equals x squared minus 4. This first one is a parabola going up. But let's see if the definition makes sense. It says that to be an even function, f of negative x is the same thing. So let's see what negative x, what does that mean? That means I'm going to plug in negative x in place of x. So I'm putting a negative x in place of the x here. And then that would be x squared minus 4. So notice when I computed f of negative x, I get exactly the same function. Both times, I'm going to get x squared minus 4. Right? I got the same thing. So that shows me that it's true that f of negative x is actually the same thing as f of x. Now, what does that look like on a graph? So we're just going to sketch it quickly. So let's say that's 5 and negative 5. All right, so if we're going to sketch this, if we put in 0 for x, we get negative 4 for y. So this is a point on our graph. Now, there's different ways of getting the parabola from here. I like to say, well, this is going to look like the graph of y equals x squared. So I could go over 1 and up 1, and I get a point over here. Okay? The other way to do it is actually plug in 1 for x and make a chart. But if you plug in 1 for x, you get 1 squared minus 4, which is negative 3. So notice that's the point, 1, negative 3. And then let's say if you plugged in for 2 for x, you would get 0, because 2 squared minus 4 is 0. The way I do it is I think of going over 2 and up 4, etc. And if you plug in 3, you're going to get up here at 5, etc. Well, here's the cool thing about an even function. Every point on the right side of the y-axis, there's going to be a corresponding point on the left side. So you go straight across the same distance. And that's because if you plug in 1, you get the same value for y as if you plug in negative 1, right? 1 is on the right side of the y-axis and negative 1's on the left side. The y value is the same. So instead of plugging in all those numbers for even functions, it's completely symmetric across the y-axis. So if we have a point right here, there's this corresponding point over here, etc. Now that's not true of all parabolas because if the vertex point is not on the y-axis, that would not work. So in other words, if you had some parabola over here, that's not symmetric across the y-axis. Okay? All right, what about this one? F of x equals the absolute value of x plus 1. Not sure if you already have graphed absolute value functions, so we'll go ahead and do that now in case it's new to you. But first, let's just take the definition. Is it true that f of negative x is going to be the same answer as f of x? So is the absolute value of negative x the same thing as the absolute value of x? And actually, that's true. If you put in a number like 5, if you take the absolute value of it, you're going to get the same thing as if you put in the absolute value of negative 5. So the absolute value of negative x is actually the same thing as the absolute value of x plus 1. So let's make a quick little table of ordered pairs for this function, x and y, let's say. We'll just put in some numbers for x and y. So if you put in 0 for x into this function, we'll have absolute value of 0, which is 0, plus 1. Okay, let's put in 1 for x. So if we put in 1 for x, we'll get 1 plus 1, which is 2. Now the whole point is that if it's even, that means I should get the same answer if I put in negative 1, right? So if I put in negative 1 for x, I'm taking the absolute value of negative 1, which is 1, so I get 1 plus 1, also 2, which is exactly the definition of an even function. If we put in 2, the absolute value of 2 is 2 plus 1, or 3, and I should get the same answer for y if I put in negative 2, which I do. So just in case you had never graphed that before, I wanted to give you a little chart. And then we're going to graph this. All right, so let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, or 6, etc. Okay, so let's plot these points. We have 0, 1. We have 1, 2. And then I also have negative 1, 2, which again, note, it's right across the y-axis. There's another point. We have 2, 3. And we have another point over here. If you continue, you'll find out you have 3, 4, negative 3, 4, etc., and you actually get this V shape. So these are examples of even functions. Okay? One's a parabola where the vertex is on the y-axis, and the other is the absolute value function, one of an absolute value function, where the vertex, this point in the center, is also called the vertex, the of this absolute value function. So both of them are on the y-axis. Okay. So those are just two examples of even functions, and to find out if something's an even function, you can graph it and look at it, say, well, if I've got one point over here, is there always a point on the other side? So if you have a point on the left side of the y-axis, is there a corresponding point to the right, straight across, same distance. So in other words, this distance to the y-axis has to be the same distance, right? Straight over. Right? Algebraically, you put in f of negative x and you see if you could make it look exactly the same as f of x. And so that's what we're going to do now. I'm going to give you some possibilities of functions, and then we're instead of graphing it, we'll just plug in f of negative x, so we'll figure out what that is, and we'll find out if it's exactly the same as the original function. And if it is, then we know it's an even function. All right, so let's determine whether or not each function is even or not. All right, so to do this algebraically, we're going to see what f of negative x equals. So remember that means I replace x with negative x. All right, now what's a negative x to the fourth power? That's the same thing as x to the fourth, because a negative sign to the fourth power is going to be positive. And oops, I forgot to put the squared here. And then I have minus 2, and then I have a negative x, that quantity squared. Negative x times negative x is x squared. Does that look exactly the same as the original function? Yes, it does. So this is an even function. All right, let's do the next one. So I'm going to plug in g of negative x. So I've got to plug in negative x in place of the x. And what do I have here? A negative x squared will be a positive x squared, right? Because the negative squared will give me positive. And then I forgot to put the minus sign here. Let me make that a little more clear. Plugging in negative x. And what's this? Minus 3 times minus x, that's going to give you a plus x. Is that the same as the original function? No, it's not, because, oops, I forgot. Sorry for these mistakes. I forgot the 3. I have the x squared. That's got the correct sign, but in my original function for g, I have a minus sign in front of the 3x, and here I have a plus 3x. So these are not exactly the same. So this one is not even. So here's an example if you have it in function notation. But remember, you could write functions in different ways. You could have a set of ordered pairs. So let's try these. So determine whether or not each function is even or not. All right, so remember what it's saying. If you have any x in the domain, you also have a negative x in the domain with the same y. So what we've got to check is that for each value of x, so let's check out. Here's a 2, and I got a y value of 4. So that means I should have another ordered pair with a negative 2 and the same y value. And there it is. I've got a negative 2 with a positive 4 as well. So remember, if x, it's saying xy and negative xy have to both be in the domain. All right, anytime you have an xy, you also are going to have a negative xy. All right, what about 0, 5? So we have 0, 5. So if I take the opposite of that, well, the opposite of 0 is still 0. So I still have that ordered pair, right? 0, 5. So no problem here. Okay, looks over here. We have a negative 1, 3. So that means I would have to have a positive 1, 3. And there's my positive 1, 3. So this is an even function. Now, if you graphed it, you'd be able to tell. Let's see if I can graph this kind of quickly. So I've got to make a lot of little marks here. So we have 2, 4, which is right here. We have 0, 5. We have negative 1, 3. We have negative 2, 4. And we have 1, 3. And so hopefully you see, not very, I know it's kind of small. For every point you have to the right of the y-axis, there's one directly on the opposite side, same distance away. Okay, so that's a way you can visualize it as well. Okay, what about this other one? So, oh, by the way, this is, yes, it's even. Okay, so let's do the next one. For every y, I mean, I'm sorry, every x value, there has to be a negative x value with the same y. So here I have a 4, okay, and I've got, that means the y value is 5. I should have another ordered pair, negative 4, 5. So do you see another ordered pair, negative 4, 5? No, you don't. There's a negative 4, 1, totally different. So this one, because there's no, since there's no negative 4, 5, it doesn't matter about the rest of it. This is not going to be even. And by the way, we do have the 3, 2, and then the negative 3, 2. So it doesn't matter. It means for every ordered pair, anytime you have an xy, there has to always be a negative xy, no matter what. All right, so that's what an even function is. We'll be going over what odd functions are in the next video. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.